even when jumping blind. Yeah, I should be able to do that. I made a Mario Maker level once where I made you jump blind. The blind jump. One of my Mario Maker 2 levels. So, I have experience platforming blind. Might do a little gimmick let's play of playing blind in the future. Something I thought about doing at some point. In all honesty, Super Mario Bros. 1, level 1-1, the most famous platforming stage of all time. The one I've played by far the most, even of course I classic remixed twice in Super Mario Maker 2. I once thought I should be able to play that one blindfolded. I might do that in the future at some point. But it's pretty hard to do because it's pretty hard to prove that you're actually playing it blindfolded. It's really hard. It's pretty easy to just say you're blindfolded. You actually have to have a webcam on you and everything. And I don't want to do a face reveal quite yet. Come on! That way. Get out of the way! I missed! This was horrible. I was playing horrible. But I have the margin, so I don't really mind. But Dizzy Dancing as a minigame should win. I believe that just broke my clean sweep, because I don't believe I've lost Dizzy Dancing yet. Unless I'm misremembering. But I clearly lost this time, so clean sweep is over on that one. Even if it already was the case. In that case, it would still be the case now. Another battle. Well, we're getting plenty of those. We still have a lot of facelifts to show off. Yoshi's face is one we haven't seen yet, for one. And we still need to see the blooper minigame at Crazy Cutters. But none of them were present. Alright, Boo. If people leave him for me. Which they do. Okay. I still have faith in you, Boo. You're going to win eventually for me. Hopefully. Let's go, Boo. All that faith I've been pouring into you. Oh, they both fell. Let's go, let's go. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Finally. All that trust, I knew it would pay out eventually. The Bob-omb and the Womp both fell, otherwise I don't think I would have passed them. That was clearly in third. Yeah, you need some luck in this minigame. That's where it's a luck-based minigame for. Always a tradition in Mario Party games. Luck-based minigames in the battles. And they later start doing it in dual minigames as well. What am I saying? One of the minigames in this game, one of the dual minigames in this game is a luck-based minigame. It just becomes a little bit more frequent later on. The dual minigames really become comparable to the battle minigames at some point. I don't really think it's the case in this game yet. The dual minigames are all... Come on! The dual minigames are all board-themed in this game anyway. That changes from Mario Party 3. And it became a little bit more loose minigames, like every other minigame in this game already is. They're directly related to the board in this game. Right, guys, you go destroy each other. Stay away from me! Yeah, that's the downside of my strategy. Sometimes they still go for you, even if you stay in your corner. And if they hit you, yeah, you turn around. Usually you can't protect your balloon if that happens. It's still a better strategy than just going. I usually end up dying a lot sooner if I do it like that. Alright, Tipsy Turny. I should be able to win you. I know I can do that. I'm just failing to do so far. I missed one again. Come on, I still have time. Gotcha! See, I can win this minigame. I knew I can. I knew I said I didn't like the minigame, but if I win the minigame, I suddenly like it a lot more. Don't count on it happening from now on. It usually is a fluke if I win this one. It's mostly my own damn fault if I lose it. That's one of the reasons I don't like it, because I usually blame myself for not winning it. I always have the feeling I should be able to get that final tile. Usually it's it ends up me missing one of the tiles. Alright, 2 versus 2. Final destruction duet would be nice. Oh, it's in there. Just doesn't get picked. We still have the second destruction duet variant we haven't seen yet. I don't want to do the wings. It's annoying to do when the computer sucks at steering. Right, let's go. I know I've won it at least once while flapping the wind, so I know I can do it. If DK proves to be a better pilot than Wario last time, super hard computer, ended up being a super bad pilot. Ooh! How did that miss us? Yeah, we're winning this one. We're definitely winning this one. Yeah, the fact that the opposing team are not super hard computers, but regular hard computer also helps, of course. They're getting hit by absolutely everything. Easy win, very easy win. They were barely past the halfway point. Alright. How are we doing? I have more than 100 coins over second place already. And I'm still not satisfied. I still think I'm losing way too many minigames. I should be better at this game by this point. After playing it so many times, I should be able to destroy the competition. Not just beat the competition, but actually destroy them. Right, we're getting no battle games this turn. That's a first. Hexagon heat? No. Would have been nice. Bumper balls, we're getting the first one, the most boring one. The second one is clearly my favorite. This one is a little bit boring in all honesty. Even though bumper balls is a mini game I definitely appreciate, not the mini game is boring, just the arena is. Because I know there are more fun arenas to play around on. DK, come on. We're getting nowhere this way. Alright, I'll just go. If the computer players don't go towards the edge, you're going to have to force them to do so by going on the edges yourself. Fine, no. I thought he was finally gonna go to the edge. No, I'm in a danger zone. It's not in the stars today. This minigame draws a lot. It is a minigame, especially on the higher difficulties, that draws happen a lot. It's pretty hard to strategize your way towards victory here. It's pretty easy to just stay in the middle, and in the middle you don't really have any danger, so one of the downsides in this minigame. If nobody takes any chances, there's no way anything is going to happen. Especially on the regular first arena. In the second and third, because of all the obstacles, more things tend to happen. Therefore, not so much inviting towards a draw. That first one's really hard to actually win. Alright, we are closing in on the final 5 turns. When it comes to 1 versus 3 minigames, I see Move to the Music's second variant has not shown up yet. I don't see that happening. Ah, stupid Boo! You're in the way! Ah, dang it! It's what I warned about, early project. If you get stuck between two players, or a non-playable character in this case, and a player, you don't stand a chance. You're out. Come on, Yoshi. Save the team. 3, 2... Thank you, Yoshi. I had a very bad starting position. I still win. Ah, he gets one single coin out of it. Doesn't help him keep his third place, though. Still gets last place now. Yoshi took a while to get off the ground, but he is off the ground now. Finally passed up on DK. Good job dodging those battle spaces, guys. He also lands right in front of it, yeah. Man, there was a moment where every single turn was a battle game, sometimes even two. Hi Yoshi, I'm going to be on your team next minigame. Destruction Duet second variant would be nice. So you can scratch that one off the list entirely, even though it was the final minigame to show up. Yeah, it's the second one. The minigame that took the longest to show up. Three different variants and all three of them showed up in this minigame stadium part of the project. What are the chances? We're done here. Finish! 14 seconds to destroy the statue. The other team was not very far behind me, I saw, but they were behind us, so they are not winning. I'm breaking 200. Would be nice if I can reach 300. But there are not that many turns left, so I'm actually going to have a battle game to show up, or some bonus minigames to show up, like Deep Sea Salvage. Yeah! Quicksand Cachet, that's where I usually can really bank. Otherwise, I don't think the 300 is happening. Magnet Carta is pretty useless. Magnet Carta is the bonus mini game you can't really score high in this game, I think. I believe it only showed up once. It's one of the mini games that showed up once and then never again. Magnet Carta, now that I think about it. We have not seen that one at all. Alright, move to the music. Let's get that final song. No. Damn it. Again the first song. Man, I still can't believe this. I need to pay attention. This was right. The final one is B. ZZBB. You're making this way too easy, Yoshi. Down Z. Z. B. Z. You made it way too easy. Yeah, I still can't believe that Destruction Duet, the final minigame to show up and having three variants, it's already out. We've already seen all three of them. Shows up twice in the battle mode and shows up here. We are done with Destruction Duet. But Move to the Music does not want to go that way. Even though it showed up like four times now, and all four of them the same song. Pretty hilarious how things like that can work out. Did you just jump over me? Peach? Rude. Let's get the bonus. We can get to 223. Yeah! And another four-player game. All right. Oh, yeah, I was afraid that one was going to show up. Either that one or Skateboard Scamper. Alright, let's go. I barely missed winning this one last time. now. Oh, yeah, it wasn't time. Thank you. The very first time this minigame showed up, I won, I remember, on Pirate Land. Did not win it ever since. Finally. Some proof I can win it more than once. That it was not a coincidence. You need to get lucky. Oh, it's been a while, Battle Games, but finally, we're back. Right, let's bank on the minigame. Let's see if I can reach that 300. Yoshi's face would be nice. It is a possibility. Nope. It's a Mario. It's a me. Oh, this looks painful. Yoshi, I want your face. Even though I don't think it's a fun thing to pull on reptiles' faces. Leave reptilians alone. They're way too cool. Don't pull on their faces. Still needs to happen, though. Just not right now. I'm pulling my own face now. It hurts pretty bad. This looks nice. And it was. No perfect this time, but it was good enough. Oh, two third places, apparently. Right, I win 36 coins. 56, I know, but I laid in 20, so I gained 36. Alright, 300 is still a possibility. I knew I had to have a battle game for that. Alright, three turns. If I win all three minigames, I end up with 299, so a bonus minigame needs to show up, or a minigame where I can score loose coins. And I need to win every single minigame. Let's not forget about that. But it's still possible. The dream is still real. 300th challenge, let's go. We need Honeycomb Havoc for that, but it doesn't show up. Shell shocked. I cannot score over 10 coins. And it's Shell Shock number 2, so we can scratch that one off the list as well. The final arena we have not seen. The one with the fork pipe. Go away, Yoshi. I see you creeping up on me. Right, you and me, Peach. Come on. Are you gonna go hide behind the pipe? I see. I can still reach you. Come on. You're going down first. No! How did I miss her? I see a bubble floating around here somewhere. It says 300 coin stream. It just bursted. How did I lose that? I should have had her. My cowardly strategy in... I also use in bumper balloon cars, by the way. You see me use the same strategy here. I usually just stay in my little corner, let the computer players take care of themselves. And I usually, from my corner, start shooting at the other people. It didn't work out too well this time. I'm not getting to start, so those 10 coins are not going to help me either get the 300 coins. And what do we have? We have no mini games where I can score over 10 coins, so Hexagon 8. I've been losing this minigame way too much. I screw around with this minigame way too much. Me having way too much fun getting these other computer players. What? No! No! And things like that happen. If I play this minigame seriously, I know I can win this every single time. Yoshi, where are you going? But that's just the thing. This minigame is not fun to play seriously. It's way too fun to screw around in. But it does help me get a fourth place in this minigame way too many times. Yeah, that 300 coins dream was pretty far off. If it was still a thing, I would have played this one a lot more seriously, I think. I would have actually tried. It's way too fun to ground pound other people, but it's also pretty easy to fall off if you do things like that. Doesn't matter. Even screwing up can be a lot of fun. That's what we're all doing this for. Not to win, but to have a lot of fun. And you don't necessarily have to win to have a lot of fun. That's the message I'd like to give you when playing Mario Party. Winning is fun, but having fun is more fun. And having fun is not necessarily the same thing as winning. Even though it does help. Right, final minigame. I was ready to throw my controller away because Look Away was going to show up, but apparently... Nope. No final variant of this one. We also need to see a final ball over variant, but this is not the one we want to see. And Yoshi's going to win this. Two of us are out. The final one shouldn't be a problem. You can even throw a spare if he hits the final coin pin. Which he does. Finish! No strike. It is possible to throw a strike in this minigame, by the way. I have not seen that happen at all. Like, when playing on my own, both in Mario Party 1 and 2. Even harder in 1, because you only get one throw there. But I did see someone else do it at one point, so I know it's possible. Alright, the turns have ended. The question remains, who shall emerge victorious? Well, who do you think? Well, let's count everyone's coins. It's a pretty close game, right? Now, I shall announce the final results. Victory belongs to... Mario, congratulations! Surprise, surprise. Still good times, though. Still good times. A lot of fun to do. Right, another board I win. Even though it's not an official board, it is board enough to call a board. And I win, hands down, more than double what second player has. There's no detailed results you can view here. That's not... being kept track of here, so we can immediately skip on to throwing in all of the coins into the pot. Because of course, even those the coins you win here also count towards your coin box. So you can save up to buy mini games. I already got all of them. Not really true. You still need to buy the item mini game that shows up from Bowser Land. But trust me, that will be taken care of. Because next time we're going back into Minigame Stadium and do the final mode in that, the Duel mode. And for that, the Bowser Land Duel will be ready. Don't worry, even though Bowser Land has not been played yet, I will make sure that game is available to us when we start playing. That's easily done by simply going into Bowser Land for a minute. Make the Duel minigame show up and it should be unlocked. You don't really have to play the board for that in its entirety. So we can... show off the dual mode in its full glory with even that minigame from that board. Even though it has not officially shown up, we can still cover it in the dual mode. So the dual mode feels complete as well. But that'll be tomorrow when I continue with this project. Yes, tomorrow is also going to be Mario Party, and even the day after tomorrow. I promise you 4 videos this weekend. So, see you guys next time. Treeks out.